IGBT. IGBT stands for Insulated Gate Bipolar Junction Transistor. And IGBT is a, which is made by combining the qualities of a MOSFET and a BJT. The IGBT offers high input impedance like a MOSFET and low on-state power loss as a BJT. So combining with this both quality, the IGBT is developed. IGBT, whenever anyone want this both quality in a semiconductor device, one can go with the IGBT. So now we will study the characteristics of IGBT with this kit and plot a VI characteristic graph between voltage of gate emitter junction and collector emitter junction with the current respectively, and also we are going to understand the switching characteristics with this gate. So now we will further move on to the circuit descriptions and experiment.
The trainer gate of characteristics, explaining the characteristics of IGBT. The order code for this trainer gate is 46565. The circuit is shown at the kit for the easy understanding of for students. This is the DC voltmeter of 0 to 20 volt voltage range. This is DC voltmeter for 0 to 200 volt voltage range. And this is the dual option DC ammeter, which can work on 0 to 20 milliampere or 0 to 200 milliampere, so on. These are the IC regulated power supply of 0 to 10 volt. Or we can show this the P1 port, and this is the IC regulated power supply of 0 to 60 volt for the gate, so for the collector emitter junction, and this power supply applies to the gate emitter junction. Now we are also providing user manual and patch codes to perform the experiment with this kit. So now we will move on to our first experiment, which is the plot of VI characteristics with this of IGBT. Now we are going to perform our first experiment, which is to plot the VI characteristics of an IGBT. For this, the circuit is given and the connection are also given and described in the procedure. So we go on with the circuit and connect and make the circuit connection as per the circuit diagram described in the manual. For this, connect positive terminal of 0 to 10 volt supply to this 100 ohm 1 volt resistance. Now connect positive terminal of gate to positive of voltmeter 0 to 20 volt, and negative terminal for this DPM to negative of the voltmeter 0 to 20 volts. Now connect positive or collector terminal to DC voltmeter positive, which is the 200 volt range voltmeter, and negative of this terminal to negative of voltmeter. Now connect negative of this ampere meter to negative of the ampere meter shown at above, and positive of this ampere meter to positive. So these are our circuit diagrams connection. Always verify the circuit connection when you before power on the equipment, that circuit connections or patch codes are properly connected. So we now power on this circuit. So we power on the circuit. Always remain the potentiometer P1 and P2 on the minimum position. Now as per the circuit procedure, set the gate emitter voltage now power on the circuit, and as per our first experiment now as per the experiment procedure, increase the voltage of P1, that is voltage of gate emitter junction, approx 4 volts. So this is the voltage of VGE, it is about 4 volt. Now gradually increase in steps of around 5 volts the value of P2, which is the collector emitter junction, and note down the value of current IC shown at the ammeter. So this is at the 5 volt approx, and at this time note down this reading 1.1. similarly increase the voltage again in 10 volt, again note down the reading. Similarly as at 15 volt, then as 20 volt, 25 volts, and so on. Note down the voltage and current and plot the graph between voltage and current as per shown in the manual. You will find out your graph for VI characteristics of then IGBT will be as per this plot of the voltage and current characteristics. So now we move on to our second experiment. For this, first switch off the power, turn the potentiometers to the minimum position. For second practical, the circuit connections will be remain the same. Now in this section we will plot the graph of between IC current and the V collector emitter junction voltage. First we have plot the graph between gate and emitter junction and IC. Now we will plot the graph between the voltage of collector emitter junction and the IC current. For this, first power on this circuit and remain this value of P1 at the 0 point, and value of P2, which is the voltage of collector emitter junction, set this value around 10 volts and let it be at the 10 volt. Now gradually increase the value of P1 in the steps of 1 volt and note down the IC current. So at 1 volt note down the current, which is 0. At 2 volt also note down the current, at which is 0. At 3 volts note down the current, at this time it is also 0. Now as the current, as the voltage increase more than 4 volts, you will start finding out the current, because the at 4 volts supply the collector, sorry, the gate emitter junction will be triggered, and the voltage through the collector and emitter junction, sorry, current from the collector emitter junction will be start passing. Now at 5 volts note down the current, you will see the current will suddenly and gradually exponentially increase the value here. Now it is the 50 milliamps, so on. Repeat these steps at 6 volt, at 7, at 8 and 9, once you plot the graph between the voltage of collector emitter junction and the IC current, sorry, the voltage of gate emitter junction and the IC current, you will find out your graph will be same as the shown in the manual. So this is the characteristics of voltage and current of an IGBT. Here the voltage of collector emitter junction has around 0 volts because the collector emitter junction is now working as the short circuit, that's why the current is maximum and voltage is minimum. Now decrease the value again and switch off the kit. So now we move on to the our third experiment, which is to study the switching characteristics of a power IGBT. For this we need a function generator to generate the square waveform and a CRO to observe the output waveform of switching frequency. For this, make the circuit diagram as per shown in the manual. So we make the connection as per the circuit diagram. For this, first connect DC voltmeter between collector and emitter terminal and short circuit the ampere meter section to find out the output at this output terminal. Now power on the circuit. Connect the function generator to the input terminal of this circuit and connect a CRO to the output terminal of the circuit. Now set the function generator frequency to square wave. This is the square wave. Now set the frequency 10 kilohertz. So this is the 10 kilohertz frequency and amplitude around 12 volt or more than 10 volts. You can set it 13, 14, 15, whatever you want, but it should be more than 10 or 12 volts. Now observe and set the P2 potentiometer voltage, which is the collector meter junction voltage, around 15 volts. So this is the 15 volts we have applied to the collector meter junction. Now you see the output at the CRO. This is the switching frequency output, which is at the 10 kilohertz. Now as you increase the frequency to 11, 13, 14, increase this frequency from 10 kilohertz to 100 kilohertz or some more than 100. This is the switching characteristics of this power IGBT you are observing at the CRO. Once you see the output waveform is distorted or have fluctuations, a good amount of fluctuations, stop at that frequency and you will find out that the maximum switching frequency of this IGBT. So at this frequency, which is more than 120 and 120 hertz, sorry, kilohertz. So right now the output is slightly started distorting. So this is the maximum switching frequency. At this, this power IGBTs work as in a switching. As you decrease the frequency, the waveform is decreasing with the input frequency. So this is the switching characteristics practical of this power IGBT. So for any queries and questions, you can refer to the user manual or you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you for today. So now we move on to our last experiment, which is to study the switching characteristics of a power IGBT. For this, make this connection as per the circuit diagram. Also, we need a function generator here and a CRO to see the output of the switching characteristics of this IGBT. For this, we are going to start the connection as per the circuit diagram. Now, connect a DC voltmeter at the collector emitter junction of this IGBT. And short circuit the ampere meter dotted line here shown in the circuit. Now connect the function generators output cord positive to this resistance terminal and negative to this negative terminal, and now connect the CRO to observe the output, negative to the negative terminal and positive to the positive terminal of this circuit. So these are connection we have made up. Now first power on the circuit and set the value of P2, which is the voltage between collector and emitter junction, to around 15 volts. So this is the 15 volts. Now we have to set the input of function generator. For this, select the square wave and select the frequency of this square wave, which is 10 kilohertz. Now select the amplitude. Make the amplitude of this square wave is more than 10 or 12 volts VPP. So we will set it to the 14 volts. Now turn back to the frequency. So this is the input from the square wave generator or a function generator given to this circuit, and now at 15 volt the output of this switching frequency is shown at the CRO. You can see the waveform at the CRO. This is the output waveform of this IGBT. Now as we increase the switching frequency, the frequency output also increases. You can see and observe it at the CRO. Switch the input of frequency to from 10 kHz to 100 kHz, and at the point you see the distortion like this in the waveform. So it will be observed as the maximum switching frequency of this IGBT. So this is around 120 Hz, which is more than 100 kHz. 100 kHz is the standard frequency, but in practical the frequency can be much more than that. So you will see the distorted output of the waveform. So this is the maximum switching frequency of this power IGBT. And this is the minimum. At this time the output is very crisp and clear. So this is the minimum 10 kHz frequency from this IGBT. So this is our practical and different characteristics and also switching characteristics of this IGBT with this trainer kit. For any queries and questions, you can refer to our user manual or you can contact to the Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you for today.